Good morning, everyone. It's Robert from On My Turntable. Hope you made a great morning this morning. It is Thursday morning, as always, a coffee kind of morning. A nice fresh cup of coffee. I love it. It tastes so good. Cheers, everyone. Hope everyone's doing well. I still have to catalog a lot of this stuff and clean it up, but from my great friend Luis Martinez. He sent me some amazing VCLT, especially this one here, the Steve Miller Band. Recall the Beginning, A Journey from Eden. I've listened to it once. I still have to listen to it again. It's a great album. I love it. Completely different than a lot of his newer stuff. But based on that album, I decided to show you my Steve Miller Band collection. I don't have a huge collection, but some great stuff in this one. So again, thank you, Lewis. You're an amazing person. So giving, because that's the third VCLT he sent me. And I've asked him, what do you want? He doesn't want anything back. So Steve Miller Band, awesome American rock band from San Francisco, formed in 1966. Led by the great Steve Miller on guitar, lead guitar, and lead vocals. When I was younger, I wore this album out. This isn't the original, obviously, but the Steve Miller Band Greatest Hits 1974 to 1978. I wore out the cassette of it, wore out the CD of it, and I'm glad to have it on vinyl. You've got Swing Town, Jungle Love, Take the Money and Run, Rockin' Me, Serenade, True Fine Love, The Stake, The Joker, Fly Like an Eagle, Threshold, Jared Airliner, Dance, 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 The Beautiful Wintertime, and Wild Mountain Honey. Amazing collection of, there's some cool inner sleeve stuff going on there. And love the label. It's on the Capitol label. But yeah, I wore this one out. Just a wonderful stuff. Their music, combination of blues rock, psychedelic rock, and pop rock. I love the twang and the guitars on a lot of the tracks. In 2016, Steve Miller was inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as a solo artist. Getting back to this one, it sold over 13 million copies. No really, sorry, no slouch of an album for sure. One of my favorite greatest hits ever. It's amazing. Mr. Boss Gags, who again, I still have again cataloged this stuff. Who Lewis sent me a couple of. This is amazing. They're both amazing albums. His pretty much his debut, I believe. And this one here. Mr. Boss Gags was part of the Steve Miller Band from 1967 to 1968, doing some lead vocals, lead guitar as well. Amazing guitarist, by the way. Doug Clifford from CCR played in the Steve Miller Band in 1975. So he had some cool people in there. Some of the vinyl that I have, this is a re-release, obviously. But this is Brave New World. It's a gatefold on beautiful yellow vinyl. Brave New World, third studio album released in 1969. It's voted 676 of the top 1,000 albums in 2000. Paul McCartney played on this one. It wasn't in the list of players. He was under Paul Roman in the credits. Played on the track My Dark Hour. Multi-instrumentalist Mr. McCartney is, played drums, guitar, and bass on the track as well. So really good album. Amazing stuff. Then you have Your Saving Grace, another great find. this is also a gatefold. Okay. Your Saving Grace, the fourth studio album, released in 1969. More psychedelic rock and blues rock on this one. You got a little girl just passing a fancy in the midnight dream. Don't let nobody turn you around. Baby's house, motherless children. The last wombat in Mecca. Feel so glad in your saving grace. The title track. Don't recall what. This is a VCLT as well. I believe also from Lewis. Because of the MoFi sleeves. It's on the Capitol label. Lewis loves his Steve Miller for sure. Glyn Johns, who plays tambourine on this one. And who else is on here? Lonnie Turner. Yeah, cool stuff. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Again, this one I just showed you from Lewis. Recall the beginning, A Journey from Eden. I've listened once to this one. I love it. Completely different. Again, MoFi sleeves. Capitol label. Lewis just outdoes himself all the time. But this is a really, really great album. Jim Keltner is on this one. Roger Allen Clark. Steve Miller, of course. But it's kind of a departure from the stuff that you're normally used to from Mr. Steve Miller and the Steve Miller Band. But really, really good. Really, really good. That was released in 1972. And then going into more commercially successful stuff. This is, if I can get it out of the sleeve, this is The Joker. Love that album cover. Okay. Another gatefold in here. It's on the, this one's on the Red Capitol label. Okay. The Joker, what can you say about this one? Combination of live and studio releases. Definitely change in direction from the band, from more psychedelic to more blues rock and pop rock. 1973 release, hit number two in the charts and went platinum in the States. Big hit, of course, the title track, The Joker, on that one. Then you have 1976's Fly Like an Eagle. Awesome, awesome album. Getting more commercially successful as I go. Again, on that Capitol label. As I drop my notes. So Fly Like an Eagle, ninth studio album. By Steve Miller Band, released three singles off of this one. Fly Like an Eagle, the title track, Take the Money and Run, and Rock Me. Quadruple platinum. So again, he's just shooting up the charts on this one. Ranked 400 of the top 1,000 albums of all time in 2000. And then you've got possibly one of his most commercially successful albums, or getting close to it, Book of Dreams. Okay, they just keep on getting better and better and better. This is the 10th studio album by the Steve Miller Band. This one's got the original lyrics. Beautiful labels on that one. This one is 1977 release. Another three single release, Jet Airliner, Jungle Love, and Swingtown. Hugely successful album. Reached top 10 in many, many countries, including Canada. Awesome, awesome stuff. Then you got their 12th studio album, Abracadabra. Okay, this is another remarkable album. Capitol label. Abracadabra, 1982 release, number one hit in many, many countries, including Germany. Title track was a huge, huge success. You also have Cool Magic, Keep Me Wondering Why, Give It Up, Goodbye Love. Most of the album wasn't not written by Steve Miller. It was written by drummer Gary Malabar, who brought some tracks over from another band he was in called Tracker. Miller was really impressed by the tracks and decided to make the album using those tracks. So I think Steve Miller only wrote two tracks off of that album, Abracadabra. So really good stuff. And finally, 1977 live album, Breaking Ground. Cool, there's a famous cover there. Double album. The original lyric sheets here. No gatefold. There's also a nice booklet here showing some awesome photos. There's Mr. Miller there. Landover, Maryland, performed in front of 20,000 people at the Capitol Center. Yeah, cool stuff. Sounds really good. You've got, I'm not sure, I think it's just cool black 180 gram vinyl for this double album. Just a hit after hit after hit. Living in the USA, Space Cowboy, Shooby-Doo, Come Into My Kitchen, Wild Mountain Honey, The Window, Wintertime, The Steak, Mercury Blues, Serenade, Take the Money and Run, Jet Airliner, Space Intro, Fly Like an Eagle, Rockin' Me, The Joker, Seasons, and So Long Blues. There's the track listing there. So, awesome, awesome live concert. So there you have it, guys. There's my Steve Miller collection. Hopefully I'll keep on finding more stuff, but what I've got is pretty awesome as it is. But hope you guys have a great rest of the day. Possibly back on Saturday with another video as that work thing gets in the way. But I'm on holidays in the next couple of weeks, so I should be doing plenty of videos then. But in the meantime, have yourself a wonderful day. Love you all. We'll talk to you again soon. Bye now.